we are pushed past the limit. This is the breaking point. This is the point at which we say, no, you have pushed us far enough and we will not take any more. We will not take another step. We will fight for what's right. And I think ultimately, this is what we all need to band together for, not just for us, but for the health and the well-being of all Canadians.
Best day ever. Cold, freezing cold.
We process 500 to 800 samples a day where I work.
We don't have enough staff in there, and you get doing, especially in the blood bank, you get doing so many things at once. It gets to be dangerous.
We're running more than one camera, so we're doing, you know, a couple cameras at the same time, which potentially, I mean, we could, you know, miss a picture or something.
They're underpaid, they were overworked. We had workload issues that were tremendous, which we provided at arbitration and at negotiation, showing the employer what was going on. And we were going into central bargaining back in 2002. We had our first bargaining conference. And at that conference, we had a mobilizing plan.
They would mobilize with the goal of, if possible, having some kind of a day of action. Even though technically hospital workers aren't allowed to strike, there are things that can be done. So they started with, let's see if everybody will wear red today at work, where possible, right? Let's see if people will go out on their breaks. Let's see if they'll all take a break at the same time. Coming up with, you know, kind of the slogans that we had, like one of the slogans was public, professional, and proud. Which pretty much sums it all up. One of the other slogans, which is kind of controversial, was, without us, your doctor is only guessing. So without diagnostic imaging, without the lab work, you know, how does a doctor know how to make a diagnosis, right? So it's a team. Healthcare is a team. Yes, there's doctors, yes, there's nurses, and there's lots of them, but there's also a myriad of other professionals.
It just went on and on until we got to bargaining. Still not getting anywhere. It went from the summer to the fall, and then it just got ridiculous, and we just said enough is enough.
OPSEU brought in all the presidents for a day for a meeting, and the bargaining team, very frankly, got up at the mics and basically told the members that we were not going to, like, if we signed this memorandum, we were not going to do well. And so February 13th was set as the date. And then it was up to the team to go out to the locals and try to mobilize them. I have to say, my local was the worst meeting I've ever been to, because it's hard. It's hard to stand in front of people that you know and care about and say, we have to do this. And they said, like, could we lose our jobs? And I said, yes, yes, we could. One thing is for sure, if it's Patty and I standing out in front of the hospital that day, we will both lose our jobs. I said, if we are all out there together, I can't see how they can fire all of us. So our only strength is in numbers, and that's what we have to do.
This is our opportunity to help our members, to help hospitals, to help the government understand what we actually do. Let's really bring it out there. And the OHA had put in a complaint that we were campaigning for a strike. We said, no, it's a day of action. It's not a strike. It's only one day. It's not going to be a strike. And we will make sure that all the hospitals are staffed enough so that if there's an emergency, they will be looked after. And if they need us, we'll come in from the line. It's not a big deal.
Patty and I and a couple of other stewards were standing out in front of the hospital thinking, oh Lord, like, hopefully we're not the only ones standing here for the day. And then we saw people coming from the parking garage down the street, and we didn't recognize them immediately because all you could see was anybody's eyes. Everybody was wearing snow suits and hats. And I remember saying, oh my God, that's Jean. Oh, that's so, and the next thing we knew, the street was lined with our people. And it was a cold day, but it was like one of the best days of our lives.
And, you know, there's lots of numbers to show how many went out across the province, but I think every hospital pretty much had a representation of all the different professions out there. I think my hospital, Lakeridge, Oshawa, we had about 70 people come out, and it was quite a march around the hospitals.
You know what the issues are. You know the OHA has forced you to do this because they're ignoring the crisis that are in our hospitals. They thought you would fold. They thought your 91% vote meant nothing. They thought you wouldn't stand up. They thought they could just wear you down, and you have had enough.
The issues that drove them to the point that they needed to stand up for themselves and stand up for their patients are the same and even worse now. We were talking about short staffing. We were talking about being disrespected, not being recognized, where, you know, we, leading up to this pandemic, we have gone through SARS. We've been through H1N1. We have been through MERS-CoV. We were central at the Ebola advisory table because our members were terrified. You know, bring us now to in 2020 when the pandemic that we always worried was going to hit.
And I've never seen our profession so gutted the way it is right now. And I've never seen in all my union activism the number of professions that we have that are in the same boat. We're having problems recruiting the majority of our professions.
We're at a pivotal point, I think, where we need to really push back as United Front across all unions and all forms of healthcare, whether we can strike or not, we have the capacity to push back because we are in crisis.
And yet we have so much power. We are here because we want to stand up for Canadians. We want to stand up for our patients. We want to stand up for our colleagues. We want to stand up for everybody. And we ought to make our voices heard. We ought to band together and let everybody know we are not tolerating it anymore. We are not going to take this anymore.
When we stand together, we win. When we organize, when we fight together, we win. Healthcare workers are ready to do that again now. It's amazing. When you look, they shut down the province in 2003.
Pretty exciting, very, very exciting. It's exciting to see the members so behind the bargaining team and so believing that what they were doing was the last straw. They had to do this and they were going to.
And that night, the Ontario Hospital Association backed down and gave us central bargaining the way we had always done it.
Even though it's not a right to strike environment, arbitrators will look at what would have happened if there was a strike, right? And so we actually showed them what would have happened, right? Would there have been a strike? Yes, there would have been a strike because people were actually prepared to walk out.
The cause is much bigger than just ourselves individually. It's for our family, friends, and loved ones. You know, what kind of care would they want to receive if they had to be in a hospital? You know, we'll all need that at some point for our friends and family and ourselves. We'll be patients someday too. What kind of care do we want in public hospitals?